Welcome to my channel. In this video, let's see about stacks. Stack is a type of data structure. A data structure is nothing but a collection of data. Why do we need data structure? Because in most cases, we need our data to be organized in a specific format so that it will be easy for us to store, retrieve, and modify the information. A few examples of data structure include stacks, queues, even arrays, linked lists, etc. Stacks are based on last-in-first-out policy. Just consider a stack of plates or stack of books. Whichever book you place on top will be taken out first, right? The same concept applies here. In modern programming languages, stack is one of the abstract data types. We call it abstract because all the implementation details are hidden from us. You don't have to write code from scratch for building a stack data structure. The language itself provides you with all the built-in data structures. You just have to invoke the functions and make use of them. The most important functions or the operations used in stacks are push and pop. With push, you will be able to add the element to the top of the stack. And with pop, you will be able to remove the element from the top of the stack. You also have two other functions, isEmpty and size. IsEmpty is used to check whether the stack is empty or not. Before popping, you have to make sure that there is at least one element in the stack. This function will be useful at that time. It returns true if the stack is empty. The size function returns the size of the stack. These are the main basic operations, but a few languages like Java will provide you with a function called peek. With the help of this function, you can just find out what is on the top of the stack without retrieving or popping that element. Almost all programming languages gives you the option of generics so that you can use stacks to store any data type. It can be an integer, character, string, or date. But you should also note that data structure itself is a collection of similar data type, so you cannot mix it up in a single stack. A very good example of real-time implementation of stack is the browser back button. In any browser, whenever you click a hyperlink, the current address gets pushed into the stack. See here, when I click the YouTube video, the current address of thrillist.com is pushed into the stack. And whenever the back button is clicked, the most recent address from the stack is popped out to display that page. Other examples include undo operation in any editor. It is also used for checking the parentheses while you are compiling the code, in organizing emails wherein latest emails are showed on top. Stacks can be used to evaluate an arithmetic expression like this. A very famous algorithm was given by Dijkstra. It is known as two-stack algorithm. One of the stacks is used to store the numerical values like 3, 8 or 25. Let's call that as the value stack. The other one is used to store the operators like multiplication or square root or subtraction. Let's call that as the operator stack. Let's see the logic behind the algorithm. Read each token in the input expression. Here by token we mean each of the entry. It could either be the parenthesis, the left or right, or it could be any numerical value like 3 or 25 or 10, or it could even be the operators like multiplication symbol or square root, etc. While you read each token, if you encounter a left parenthesis, just ignore it. Left parenthesis only denotes the beginning of a sub-expression, so we don't have to do anything when you encounter that. The right parenthesis is more important. If the token is a numerical value, just push it into the value stack. Similarly, if it's an operator, push it into the operator stack. Next is the most important step. What you have to do when you encounter a right parenthesis? Before that, let's try to apply these steps in our example here. We have three left parentheses which we can ignore. Then we have the token 3. It's a numerical value, so push it into the value stack. Now we have an operator, push it into the operator stack. The next token is again a numerical value, so push it into the value stack. Now you have a right parenthesis. Wherever the right parenthesis is, it denotes the end of a sub-expression. So it's time for us to do some evaluation. You compute and finish off that mini expression. So how do you evaluate? You just need the recent operator and the corresponding values. This is where stack is going to make your job very easy. A simple pop operation will fetch you the most recent values. So pop the most recent operator, then pop the corresponding number of values. Here multiplication requires two values. Now perform the operation 18 to 3 gives 24. Push that into the value stack. So to generalize the steps, pop an operator from the operator stack. Pop the corresponding number of values from the value stack. Here we say corresponding because for most operations like multiplication or addition, you need two values. But in case of square root, you only need one value. Then do the computation. Push the result into the value stack. On reaching the end of the expression, you will be having the final result in the value stack. Now let's evaluate the remainder of the expression by following these steps. We have completed until here. Next token is an operator. So push that operator in the operator stack. The next token is square root, which again is an operator. So push that into the operator stack. Then you have a left parenthesis which you can ignore. After that you have 25, which is a numerical value. So push that in the value stack. The next token is a right parenthesis, so it's time to evaluate. Pop an operator. Square root needs only one numerical value, so just pop one value. Now compute the value. Square root of 25 is 5. Push the result into the value stack. The next token is again a right parenthesis, so you have to perform one more evaluation. Again pop an operator. For addition, you need two values, so pop two numbers from the value stack. The result is 29. Push that into the value stack. Now the next entry is an operator. Push that into the operator stack. Then you have a number. Push it into the value stack. Finally, you have a right parenthesis. So perform an evaluation. Pop an operator. Since it is a subtraction, you have to pop two numbers. The result is 19. Push it into the value stack. Whatever is left in the value stack will be your final result. Let's see the implementation using Java. Even if Java is not a language of your preference, you can easily understand this code. Let me explain the assumptions that we are making about the input expression. The first assumption is that each token is separated by spaces. And the second assumption is that the parentheses are perfectly balanced. Each left parenthesis should have a matching right parenthesis, and each sub-expression should be enclosed by parentheses. This expression is invalid. It should be like this. We only want to focus on the algorithm. That is why we are making these assumptions to avoid unnecessary input handling and error handling. Now let's get to the program. First, we are declaring an operator stack, and then this is value stack. This is just to read the input delimited by spaces. With a for loop, we are scanning each token. So if you encounter a left parenthesis, just do nothing. Then in this series of else if, we are going to consider the operator cases. The logic for pushing the numerical values into the value stack is placed in the final else condition. So this else if is where we perform the evaluation. In order to evaluate, pop the recent operator. Then you need the values. First, pop just one value and store it in the variable b. Then you should have a switch logic or an else if ladder because you have to perform a corresponding operation. If it is addition, you have to perform addition. If it is subtraction, you have to perform subtraction. We already have one of the values in v. In case of all arithmetic operations, you need one more value. So pop another value from the value stack and perform the operation. We are storing the result in V itself. In case of square root, you just need only one value, which has already been popped out in V. So just compute the square root and store it in V itself. Now the result is in the variable V. So push that result into the value stack. Once you have scanned all the tokens, just exit the loop. And then pop the value from the value stack. You will have the final result. I have the executable code in my blog. I'll add the link in the description box. If we give the input expression in the STDN inputs, you can see the result. Thank you for listening.